there's big songs that come and go, but I'm Too Sexy, it's one of those songs that it just keeps going round and round. I guess a lot of people probably want to know, where did the original inspiration for that come from? Because it's such an iconic phrase, it's such an iconic song.
Well, we had, the very briefly, it was the first time we'd ever worked on computer in 1989, and I didn't even know you could write songs on computer. I had no idea. And we had a bass loop running around for another song, and the bass loop was just going da 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 da. And we were in a basement in a guy's flat out in Acton or somewhere, and I could hear the bass line running around from the other room. And I went into his bedroom while he was working, and he had a mirror on the wardrobe, on this old Victorian wardrobe. And I just started singing, I'm too sexy for my shirt, to my shelf. And we all rolled around laughing, thought it was hysterically funny. And then Fred, we needed to make it make sense. I know, sort of. So we needed another section, and Rob had the da 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 as a guitar line. And Fred wrote the lyrics around, I'm a model, you know what I mean, and copied that top line. And that was it. And I remember when we first did it, I remember thinking nobody's ever going to play this, ever. Forget it. And then we were working in a gym, and by the time we did an interview up at, Simon Bates. And by the time we got back to the gym, everything went mad.
We did an oligarch's party in Russia, in Moscow.
Yeah.
And when we started playing Sexy, they had these huge Teletubby models just walk on. I mean, they were huge, they're like 10 foot tall. And it was about 15 people in this big baronial hall with they had all their Bentleys parked in there with their Gucci wheels. And it was that was a weird place to perform it.
Yeah.
And I was quite pleased to see the back of them, really, to be honest with you.
When we grew up, I remember in the car park, the Bentleys had spinners on, and each spinner was 10 grand. Yeah, almost as much as the car.
When a song is as big a hit as that is, as iconic, is it something that helps you, or is it an albatross around your neck?
I think it's a cross. Yeah, it's both. I think it's a lead weight and it's a golden egg. It's a bit of both.
It's earned a lot of money, so we've been very lucky. Yeah. It creates a lot of money every year. But on the other hand, you also get labelled
as stupid.
As stupid. and people think, you know, if you write a song like that, it doesn't have the gravitas that maybe, I don't know, Bridge Over Troubled Waters or another song that lasts a long time. People think you must be a bit daft to write a three chord trick, and which that is. And I think, we've always liked fun in pop music, and the people we grew up with always had an element of humour, not like whirly bow ties and nonsense. I mean,
although that can be very funny.
David Bowie and the Beatles and yeah. T-Rex and Captain Beefheart, these people had humour in their music. And we grew up with that. So.
Also, I remember seeing Dustin Hoffman talking about the Oscars, and he said it's very hard to win an Oscar with a comic role.
Yeah.
And it's the same in pop music. Yeah. You don't get any plaudits for it, for reasons which I don't understand. It's just the way it is. But I'm very proud of it. I think I love it. I'm going to have it at my funeral, I've decided. I'm going to have it at my funeral. Absolutely.